Hello guys, today I'm going to explain you menstrual cycle, which is the most important topic of NEET. So what is the menstrual cycle? It is a reproductive cycle of female primates. Occurs in female primates. Female primate includes monkeys, apes and human. Okay. Now menstrual cycle has three phases. The first phase is called the menstrual phase or bleeding phase, which is last for 3 to 5 days or 1 to 4 or 5 days. Then follicular, which is followed by menstrual phase, is followed by the follicular or proliferative phase, which is the second phase of menstrual cycle. It occurs from the 5th day of menstrual cycle, 5th day of menstrual cycle from the 5th to 14th day. Okay. Next phase is luteal or secretory phase, which is from 15th day of the menstrual cycle to 28th or 29 days. Okay, so there is a total 28 or 29 days of menstrual cycle occurs in all female primates. So now going to the phase in separate. So what happened in each phase? Okay, in menstrual phase or bleeding phase, the endometrium lining, which is formed during the follicular phase or luteal phase, is lost with blood. Okay? And follicular and proliferative phase is endometrium beginning of the endometrium preparation is start. And in luteal or secretory phase, the final preparation of endometrium is occurs. Now why endometrium is prepared? Endometrium is made. It is made for the fertilization implantation of zygote. When fertilization is occurred, the implantation of zygote is occurs in this endometrium. So, in uterus, in follicular luteal phase, endometrium should be prepared for the implantation of zygote. Okay? That means, during the menstrual or bleeding phase, the superficial functional layer of endometrium is lost with blood, and the menstrual flow, that means the first menstrual flow, which is called menses, consists of blood, disintegrated endometrial tissues, secretion of uterine glands and mucus. Okay, so what is the what happens in the menstrual or bleeding phase? The superficial functional layer of endometrium is lost with blood along with disintegrated endometrial tissues, uterine glands and mucus. Okay, along with glands and mucus. In NEET, the most important question which is frequently asked during this menstrual bleeding phase is how menstruation occurs. You note that point that the menstruation starts due to sudden reduction in progesterone secretion. That means menstruation occurs due to sudden reduction in progesterone secretion. Menstruation occurs due to sudden reduction in progesterone secretion. This is the most important point which frequently asked in NEET. Okay. Now move to the second phase, follicular or proliferative phase. This is a post-menstrual and pre-ovulatory phase because ovulation occurs as 14th day. In 14th day of follicular or proliferative phase, a 14th day of menstrual cycle. Okay, during this phase, FSH, a follicular stimulating hormone, FSH causes the growth and maturation of ovarian follicle. FSH causes growth and maturation of ovarian follicle. Ovarian follicle into Graafian follicle. Okay, then This graphene follicle secretes estrogen. This graphene follicle secretes estrogen hormone. This graphene follicle secretes estrogen hormone for the initial preparation of endometrium. That means this estrogen caused the initial preparation of endometrium. Now this increased production of estrogen by graphene follicle secretes estrogen hormone. That means this hormone level is increased in the cells. The endometrium becomes thickened and to become more vascular and glandular. Endometrium is now more vascular and glandular. Vascular means supply of blood vessels. Okay? And glandular means a formation of cells. That's why we call this phase is a proliferative phase, because proliferation means the division of cells occurs. Here the two types of proliferation occurs, in which the ovarian follicles mature into graphene follicle, and then graphene follicle starts to secrete the estrogen hormone, which can causes the initial preparation of endometrium, lead to it more thicken, vascular and glandular. That means formation of blood tissues and start supply of the blood to these endometrial tissues. That means it also occurs due to division of cells. That's why we call this phase is proliferative phase, a follicular phase. Follicular in the sense of ovarian follicle, because here is follicle is matured into the graphene follicle, so called the follicular phase. And proliferation occurs, that means divisions of cells occurs, so we call the proliferative phase. Okay. Also the glycogen and fat also accumulate in the endometrial cells. At the end of this phase, that means in the mid of menstrual cycle, that means at the 14th day, ovulation occurs. Ovulation occurs due to luteinizing hormone. Okay? And this is also most important point according to NEET. This is frequently asked question, why ovulation occurs. Ovulation occurs due to luteinizing hormone. Next phase is a luteal phase or secretory phase, which is occurs from 28 days of menstrual cycle. After the ovulation, at 14th day of menstrual cycle, after the ovulation, that graphene follicle transform into corpus luteum. This is a temporary endocrine gland. And this is also most important point according to NEET. It is frequently asked, that is, which is the temporary endocrine gland formed in the menstrual cycle. That means our answer is corpus luteum. After the ovulation, what happened during the ovulation? In ovulation, graphene follicle becomes ruptured and to release the ovum in secondary oocyte phase. Graphene follicle becomes ruptured and release ovum in secondary oocyte stage. This is called ovulation, and it happens in ovary. Ovulation happens in ovary. Understand it with the diagram. Suppose this is an uterus. Okay, it is our fallopian tube, uterus, and this is ovary. Graafian follicle mature here. This is a graafian follicle, and here is secondary oocyte. Here is ovum in this stage of secondary oocyte stage. When graafian follicle ruptures, secondary oocyte ovum released into the fallopian tube, then graafian follicle remains in ovary. Okay, graafian follicle does not move into the fallopian tube. Okay, graafian follicle is retained in ovary, is left inside the ovary, while ovum at the stage of secondary oocyte is comes into the fallopian tube. Now this graafian follicle after ovulation, this is called the ovulation. Now this, which occurs due to the luteinizing hormone. Now this graafian follicle is transformed into, after ovulation, this graafian follicle transform into corpus luteum. Transform into the corpus luteum. It is a temporary endocrine gland. Graafian follicle, which hormone secretes? It secretes estrogen. And corpus luteum is also a temporary endocrine gland. What it secrete? It secrete progesterone. Progesterone is called the pregnancy hormone. Progesterone is called pregnancy hormone. Okay. Then the corpus luteum, which is a temporary endocrine gland, is start to secrete progesterone and also some amount of estrogen also. It is also very, very important point in according to NEET, because in NEET this question is asked. I'll show you the questions of NEET along this related to this topic. Okay, so don't worry about it. I cleared the all the term and all the hormone again and hormonal interplay during the menstrual cycle. So don't worry about it. Next, this progesterone is causes the final preparation of endometrium. That means this progesterone secreted by corpus luteum is caused the final preparation of, is causes the final preparation of endometrium. And also note that point, because fertilization is possible only during this phase. Very, very important point. Fertilization is possible only during this phase. Why? Because in fertilization event, the fusion of male and female gamete occurs, and the ovum is a female gamete. After ovulation, this female gamete is released. Now it is available for the fertilization to the male gamete. So fertilization is possible only during this phase. Okay. Next, if fertilization and implantation occurs, suppose after the ovulation, now the two possibilities is occurs. First is fertilization is happened, and second is fertilization is not occurs or not happened. If fertilization is happened and implantation occurs, then corpus luteum will remain maintained. Okay. And if fertilization does not occur, Second possibility is if fertilization does not occur, this corpus luteum is degenerate. And the degenerating corpus luteum is called corpus albicans. Degenerating corpus luteum is called corpus albicans. Okay. Now, again, I repeat all the terms. Menstrual cycle has a 3 phases. Menstrual or bleeding phase. It lasts for 3 to 5 days or 1 to 4 or 5 days of menstrual cycle. Second phase is follicular or proliferative phase, in which it lasts from 5th day of menstrual cycle to 14th day. Third phase is luteal or secretory phase, which starts from 15th day of menstrual cycle and lasts to the 28th or 29th day of menstrual cycle. Okay? In this phase, menstrual or bleeding phase, the superficial functional layer of endometrium is lost with blood, along with the uterine mucus and uterine glands and mucus. Okay? Here, the menstruation occurs due to sudden reduction in progesterone secretion. We will understand it later how hormonal is interplay during the menstrual cycle. Okay, so don't worry about it. I clear all the hormonal interplay also in separate with the diagram. Okay. In this lecture, you only understand the phases of the menstrual cycle. So focus upon it. Next phase, the follicular proliferative phase. The FSH follicle is follicular stimulating hormone. Is caused the growth and maturation of ovarian follicle into the graafian follicle. That means graafian follicle is formed during the follicular or proliferative phase. Okay, that means ovarian follicle is mature because of the follicular stimulating hormone. When FSH release, the ovarian follicle get matured into graafian follicle. That means maturation occurs due to the FSH. When FSH release, graafian follicle is formed. When FSH not release, graafian follicle is not formed. Okay. When graafian follicle is formed, the estrogen is start to secrete, because graafian follicle is secrete estrogen hormone only. Not only corpus luteum also secretes some amount of estrogen, but here it is dominant. We consider it dominant form. That means I give the preference of graafian follicle. If in need comes two options, graafian follicle, corpus luteum, the estrogen hormone secrete by which gland? Graafian follicle or corpus luteum? You give the preference of graafian follicle. Okay? Because here graafian follicle only secrete estrogen hormone in the maximum amount, which starts the initial preparation of endometrium. That means it makes more vascular and glandular. Vascular in sense of the formation of blood vessels and supply of blood to the endometrial tissues, and make it more glandular by the proliferation of cells. Take at the end of this phase. Note that point. That means at the end of follicular or proliferative phase. At the end of. This phase, ovulation occurs due to luteinizing hormone. Where is luteinizing hormone comes? Where is follicle stimulating come? We understand this in next video lecture. And what is the hormonal interplay occurs in the menstrual cycle also. Okay, so you understand first of all you understand the phases happens in the menstrual cycle. Then we will move upon the hormonal interplay. Okay. So ovulation occurs due to luteinizing hormone. Third phase is the luteal and secretory phase. After the ovulation, graafian follicle is matured. Estrogen release. Then it starts to release estrogen, which causes the initial preparation of endometrium. Then luteinizing hormone is secreted and ovulation occurs. What happens during the ovulation? Graafian follicles rupture in ovary and releases the ovum in secondary oocyte stage in fallopian tube. Now this graafian follicle transform into the temporary endocrine gland which is called the corpus luteum. This will start to secrete the progesterone which is called the pregnancy hormone. Why it called the pregnancy hormone? I am explain it in next lecture. Now the luteal secretory phase, the corpus luteum start to secrete the progesterone and some amount of estrogen also. This progesterone causes the final preparation of endometrium. And fertilization is possible only during this phase. Why? Because in fertilization, male fusion of male and female gamete occurs and only happen when female gamete is also available for the fusion of male gamete. So, after ovulation, female gamete is available. So, fertilization is possible. Okay? So, fertilization is possible only during the third phase, luteosecretory phase. Next, when after the ovulation, two possibilities will be happen. First when fertilization is occurs and second when fertilization will not occur. Suppose if fertilization is occurs, then this corpus luteum will be maintained. Progesterone continue to secrete to maintain the pregnancy. That why we call the progesterone as a pregnancy hormone. Then if fertilization not occurs, this corpus luteum will be degenerate, and degenerating corpus luteum is called corpus albicans. That means we know that progesterone is secreted by corpus luteum but not by corpus albicans. That means if corpus luteum will be degenerate, then progesterone secretion will be degenerate. That means progesterone will be reduced. And in first phase, we mentioned that menstruation occurs due to sudden reduction in progesterone secretion. That means if progesterone hormone will be reduced because fertilization not occurs, corpus luteum not maintained, it will be degenerate. So progesterone secretion will be degenerate. Then endometrial layer will be lost. Endometrial tissues will be lost by the blood. So bleeding phases starts. That means reduction of progesterone triggers the beginning of bleeding phase, menstrual phase. Clear? I hope all the three phases I taught you is clear. If any ask about these phases, ask me. Okay? Thank you.